Hey everyone, welcome to the Supercross Quarantine Show presented by our friends at O'Neal Racing. I'm Don Maeda and I'm joined by Kyle Peters of the Phoenix Honda Racing Team today, who has had quite a 2021 clean sweep, total clean sweep of the Arenacross Series. How do you even explain how that felt, buddy?
Oh man, it was a wild ride for sure. There was a couple races where I got really bad starts and had to come through, and when I was in it, when it was all happening, week after week, I wasn't like super focused on it. I was just kind of like taking it race by race. I just wanted to win as much as I could. And so it, like the perfect season wasn't a big deal up until kind of like the last round. And then I was like, oh man, like this is a pretty.
Oh, we're cutting out again. So, prior to the season, obviously, your goal is to win the Arenacross Championship, right?
Yeah.
I'm sure you expected yourself to win it.
Yeah.
But did you expect to win every single race?
No, definitely not. Coming in, we knew Mike was coming in, and I knew there was a bunch of different people that with a lot of talent coming to race. So I didn't know how Mike was going to be, how fast, because I knew it had been a long time since he was on a 250. Arenacross was a little bit different, and by the end of it, he had it figured out. He was riding really, really well. So the competition was definitely there, but yeah, coming into the season, like I was the 2020 champ, so I was expecting to come in and win, and that was just my goal, is just to win as much as I could. Didn't matter what race it was, I just wanted to go out and prove like I was the champion and I can do it again. So that was super cool. When I was in the season, it wasn't the perfect season. Wasn't a big deal. Kind of like the last race. That's when the pressure definitely was there. So when I was in it, it wasn't something that was on my mind. But looking back on it, something that is really cool and special to me. No one's ever done it in Arenacross, and I'm stoked to have had the opportunity to do it and just put everything together and make it happen. So that was a really cool moment in my career.
Like how many rounds or how many mains did you win then? Because you got to think about all the starts, all the first turns, right? Everything where something could go wrong and nothing did.
Yeah. So it was 20 main events.
Jesus. 20 main events. Okay. So, you know, on a scale of, you know, like say Supercross, like, I mean, even Jeremy didn't do that, you know?
Yeah.
That many in a season. But, all right. So then you turn your attention to Supercross. Do you get to Supercross and go, holy cow, man, these tracks are bigger, not as tight.
Definitely. The whole thing is like, my whole racing, like prep for Arenacross, I just basically stay Supercross. Mm-hmm. I just kind of prepare for Supercross and then go into racing Arenacross. So it wasn't like a huge jump for me. I've been practicing at Club MX and doing the laps, doing everything I needed to do. So, but yeah, obviously the competition is insane this year with the 250 West Series. So. I knew it was going to be tough. I wanted to go get in there and battle those guys. And, I have a little bit, but my starts have been hindering me from being up there completely. So, my whole goal for Supercross was to go into battle. I knew I had the potential to podium. I had the confidence. I had the team around me to do it. And I want to be a podium guy and no matter what. So, I've got a few top fives so far, the podium. So overall, it's been a successful Supercross season. Obviously, want to go out Salt Lake with a bang and get my best finish so far. But yeah, it's been good. The whole Phoenix Honda team has been all supporting me, giving me everything I've needed. So big thanks to them. And yeah, we're keep on pushing.
Dude, how about Atlanta 3? You just kept pushing. You got swole on the last lap, right?
Yeah. Atlanta 3 was man, I really struggled in Atlanta. Like, never felt comfortable. And even throughout the day of Atlanta 3, like, I qualified 14th and 13th. And so I was far from comfortable, really struggling with the track, bike setup. And then main event, just got off to a decent start and pretty much just avoided the chaos. It was, the track was gnarly, and thankful to get out of there with a top five. And yeah, it was cool. Jalik and I kind of rode right there together pretty much the whole race, I feel like. And he ended up making a mistake, and I got him on the last lap. So, yeah.
So, dude, how about the Atlanta track? I mean, what is a minute and a half, minute 40? I mean, that's massive. That's more than twice as big as some of the smaller tracks, right? What was it racing on a track that big?
Man, it was hard for, like, it was hard, but also it was like we didn't have a lot of rhythm sections, but we did have some rhythms. The biggest thing for me was to go out there and try different things. We only got 5 or 6 laps per practice session. So you had a decently fast time laid down with no mistakes. And then you could go into trying different options through the rhythms or the whoops, different lines. So that's where it was really tough. You didn't really get very many opportunities to go out there and do something different than everyone else is doing. Or like, I was having trouble in the one long rhythm section, and like, I made 2 mistakes back to back. Lap down, or possibly something could happen. I won't even have a fast lap at all. So it was definitely interesting. Not my favorite track, but it was fun. It was a cool experience for sure.
Okay, so you're heading back to Salt Lake in 2 weekends, right? Because you don't have to race this weekend. Are you coming early? Because, man, I know that you had fun here last year during the marathon.
Yeah. I'm going to fly in Tuesday.
Nice.
For the race. We have some e-bikes on the track, so that way I'm not killing myself out there. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, just come get used to the elevation. Hopefully it's not too cold.
It's not that bad. Chase and I got here last night.
Okay, nice.
I unloaded the van and flip flops and a t-shirt. So,
okay,
so it's mid 40s. Yeah. Well, we rode bobsled this morning. We both wore windbreakers, and we were both wishing we hadn't. So
really,
yeah,
that's sick.
Not too bad.
I'm so excited to get back out there. The mountain bike trail is unreal.
Yeah,
I love it up there. So I'm stoked.
So are you still an in-cycle guy?
I am.
You are?
So, I am, yeah.
So you have a bike on the truck, you said?
So the team has the GNCC part of it.
Yeah. They race e-bikes, right?
They don't race them, but all the riders have them on the truck.
For the pre-running the course, right?
Track, yeah. So we just pulled 2 from that category and put them on the Supercross rig. So
yeah,
they were good.
Nice. So when you first signed with Phoenix, I was joking with you, like, hey man, you know, so the Phoenix Honda team, they've got their fingers in all these different aspects of off-road racing, right? It's like, you're going to try a GNCC or a, you know, enduro or a quad race. I mean, have you had the opportunity to do anything else?
So I did a GNCC last year. This actually the same one Zach did last summer, and man, I don't know if I think I just picked we just got kind of crap luck on which one we did, but it was so dusty. Like, it was the worst. Yeah, I no joke could barely see my front fender. Yeah. 5 foot out in front of me, I couldn't see anything. So that one wasn't very fun. I want to try another one this year. Mm-hmm. Just to give it another go. I don't feel like I had the best luck with the one I picked. So definitely want to do that again. And then, so Joel Hetrick, the main ATV motocross guy.
Yeah.
I want to work out a swamp deal.
Yeah.
Where I ride his for a little bit. super scared. The thumb throttle,
dude,
four
right?
wheels. I doubt I'll even get it off the ground, but I gotta give it a shot.
We need to do. You need to let me keep me posted on that.
I will.
I'll come out and cover it. You guys need to do lap times on each other's bikes, and then.
Oh, absolutely.
Like honestly, depending on the track, he might be able to go faster than you if you're on your bike and he's on his quad, right?
100%. There's been times Club MX when the four-wheeler guys have been out there riding, and they will throw down faster lap times. Like, whether we have ruts in the corners or not, like, they're insane.
Right? Psycho.
It's wild. And Joel is a freak on that thing. He'll throw it in no matter what. So, yeah, it'll be interesting. Depending on the track and how it develops and if he doesn't ruin all the ruts, then I may have a chance. But, yeah, those guys rip. They're no
Does
joke.
He have a moto background? Can he ride a dirt bike?
I've seen a couple videos of him riding a dirt bike, and he's not bad.
Mm-hmm.
Better than I thought he was actually going to be. So he's definitely got skills on both.
Yeah. Yeah, dude, keep me posted. I want to come. I'll fly out for that for sure.
That'd be sick.
So what about the summer? Are you guys doing the MX Nationals?
No, no Nationals this year. Mm-hmm. Hopefully in the next couple of years we will. The Phoenix just has so much going on that it's hard to do that as well. So this year, I guess I'll obviously – I don't think I rode enough this past summer when I didn't do outdoors. So I want to stay riding. I want to stay fit and on top of my game. But, yeah, just go help Dad a little bit at the car dealership and stay ready for whenever racing comes.
So wait, are you telling me that during the summer Kyle Peters has, like, a tie on and goes out and, oh, are you looking at this car? Can I help you?
That's me.
Yeah.
I got my shirt, my polo, my shirt tucked in. I look somewhat professional. I don't know what I'm doing, but
why does it when you sell a car or once you decide to buy a car, why does it take so dang long to leave the dealership after that? All the paperwork and registration and
Man,
do you handle that or is there someone else to do that?
So there's like general manager that handles like financing, going through the banks and whatnot. But I like the salesperson does handle a little bit of the paperwork, get you in the system, and you gotta go. There's so many different steps. It's such a process, and sometimes it takes way longer than it should. And you're just kind of, and there's nothing like the salesman can do. So you're just kind of sitting there like. Trying my hardest. I'm sorry.
So you have the summer off, but realistically, if you count all the gate drops you had, you still are going to race more than, say, a guy that only did supercross and motocross, right?
Yeah, definitely. So I still want to do racing like all summer. I want to either whether it be GNCC, local races. I'd love to do a couple outdoors if I could make it out to some close ones. So, yeah, I love to race. Anything I can do, I'll line it up.
So are you with Phoenix Honda for 22?
That it's looking David and I haven't fully signed a contract or anything, but I love the team. I love where I'm at. The team's been great to me, giving me everything I needed. So I definitely see a future with them.
Cool. Yeah. Gotta come back and defend that perfect season, right?
Do you get
Do you get a special number one plate because you had a perfect season? Does it have like gold leaf around the outside?
I wish. That'd be super cool.
Okay. Okay, I gotta ask you, what's Ripper Coffee Company? That's obviously a personal sponsor or something if you're wearing that shirt.
It is, yeah. It's a buddy of mine, from where I'm living at now. He wanted to start a coffee company, and I'd be like, yeah, I want to be a part of it. Want to help out as much as I can. And yeah, we're just in mind starting new adventures.
Nice. So is there an online outlet where people can go buy some?
Yep. So the rippercompany.com, he's starting up kind of like a coffee and like a media outlet, putting out YouTube videos, blogs, all sort of stuff. So It's just kind of starting up, but you can go buy all your coffee, all your apparel, everything, therippercompany.com, and get you what you need.
Does that name have anything to do with the ripping and the tearing?
That I don't know. I wasn't a part of the thing. So.
All right. Well, hey, Kyle, man, enjoy your weekend off, buddy. I know you've had a busy busy first 4 months of the year. And definitely hit me up when you get to Salt Lake. We need to go do some laps at
I will.
On the trails.
Absolutely. Well, I've actually been looking at trails already just to find more stuff. So definitely we'll get out on the mountain bike, get you out here out on the East Coast for
the quad showdown.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. Right on. Well, hey, Kyle Peters, thanks for joining us for today's O'Neal Supercross Quarantine Show. And we will be looking for you next Saturday in the East-West Shootout.
Absolutely. Can't wait to get back up there, come out swinging, and do a little bit of mountain biking.
Cool.